The update to Final Cut 10.4.9 has added significant improvements to the Proxy Media workflow. Up till now, Proxy Files have been fairly large when compared with Optimized Media, which could still mean large file sizes, especially if you want to share with colleagues over the internet or leave your original Optimized Media in the studio while you take a small proxy file out on the road. I'll show you how to create that small proxy-only project and how to relink to the original media back in the studio. You can now transcode to H.264 as well as ProRes proxy media. And this means that the smaller sizes of H.264 may suit your workflow better. However, the ProRes proxy will be easier for Final Cut to edit. I'll show you the differences in the file sizes, and I'll also show you what it looks like in the timeline so you can see the quality of the different proxy formats. There are a number of other improvements in the proxy workflow, and we'll work through those in the video as well. I'm Bruce McBride, and my goal is to improve your knowledge in Final Cut and to speed up your workflow. YouTube is a good way to start learning Final Cut, but it doesn't always answer your questions as you need to know them. So save time, rather than searching through YouTube, I'm able to support you. Just click the link and I'll be able to help you with your particular questions. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. The change in the workflow for proxy that's mostly going to affect most editors is the ability now to select what's called Proxy Preferred. In previous versions of Final Cut, Proxy Media was either turned on or Optimized Media was turned on. If there was a mix, then you'd be switching between Optimized and Proxy Media so that you could see both of them. If you could have switched between Proxy and Optimized Media per project, it certainly would have been an improvement. But Apple engineers have really come up with a brilliant way that solved the problem on both ways. Now when you select Proxy Preferred, the Proxy Media shows in the timeline. But if you've got clips there that don't have Proxy Media, and you do have the original and the optimized media, well, they will show as well. So the big advantage of this is that you could transcode your RED footage or your Panasonic footage into Proxy Media, but still keep your original media for the more friendly to edit format. So let's have a look at the different choices you have available. If we come to the View menu and select Optimize and Original as it is here, we can see all of these clips are showing here. There's no red overlays. It means that all of the clips are optimized. If we come down and select Proxy Only, then we look and we see that all of the clips have proxy except for these here. So this is how it used to be in previous versions. But now when we come to the View menu and select Proxy Preferred, then all of the clips are now showing. So even these ones here that don't have proxy media, they're showing in the viewer because of the Proxy Preferred option. It would prefer to use proxy media rather than optimized media. So you might say, well, why not leave it set at Proxy Preferred and not make any changes? But what will happen there is when you go to export, Final Cut will see that a proxy is selected and it will come up with this warning, which then means you can switch back to optimized media before you export. So what's the point of being able to choose between H.264 proxy media and ProRes proxy media? Well, the simple answer to this is that ProRes proxy media will allow the edit to be much smoother because it's a native Final Cut format, where H.264 proxy media will in fact stress the processor a little bit more. But on the other side is H.264 proxy media will be smaller in size than the ProRes proxy media. So when we want to create proxy media, and let's do it on this one here, we'll right-click and transcode, and you'll see that we can create proxy media here. We can create it as ProRes proxy or H.264 proxy, and we can select it at different source rates. So the smaller these are, 12.5, means that this will be a smaller file size. And if you select H.264, because it's more compressed, that will be an even smaller file size than the ProRes. So what difference does this make? So let's have a look over here. I've got a library where the proxy is at 50%. So if we bring that project into the timeline, you can see that when we're using proxy, and let's see that we are proxy only, the resolution is quite good. If we come to the 25% and bring that project into the timeline and then check, you can see this is getting a little softer, particularly if we look over these clips here, and if you look on the face, then it's not as sharp as the 50% proxy. So if we go to 12.5% and bring that into the timeline, then you can see it's considerably softer again. So the sweet spot probably is around 25%. But let's have a look at the ProRes now proxy at 50% and check that in the timeline. And there you can see that it's really very sharp. If we go to the 25% ProRes proxy and check that in the timeline, then you can see that's gone a little softer. And in some cases here, it's quite soft. Then if we come down to the 12.5%, remembering ProRes is going to be slightly better quality than H.264 at the same percentage rate. So let's try the ProRes 12% and then have a look at that. And then that's probably not really that easy to edit with. So really, the 12.5% is probably not what you want to do unless you're really stressed for size when you're editing offline. So let's go somewhere else now and we'll check what the file sizes are. So I'm going to now reveal in Finder, and these here are the same libraries that you've got over here, and it's showing you the file size. So the 264 proxy at 50% is 5.16 gigabytes. And equally, the 25% is 2.69, and the 12.5%, which is really quite small and pretty fuzzy when you look at it in the timeline, is not that much smaller. So really, this does look a better choice for the 264. Now look at the same things for the ProRes. So the ProRes at 50% is 29 gigabytes. That's a lot more than 5.16. And the 25% is at 10.86 gigabytes, which is quite a lot more than the 2.69 for the proxy 264. And really, the difference in the timeline between the 25% 264 and the 25% ProRes is fairly small. And then if we look at the ProRes 12%, then that's 4.87. So this to me is the sweet spot if you want to get your file size really small without losing too much resolution. And incidentally, if you want to have a look at the normal file size where you've got the optimized and proxy media, then that's 307 gigabytes. So this is not for editing offline. And then also as a comparison, this library is the original footage with no optimized media and no proxy media. And you can see that that's 13 gigabytes. So let's have a look at how we transcode the footage into proxy and optimized media. Now you can do this on import or you can do it after import. So on this library here, we've got no optimized or proxy media. So if we look over in the inspector, you can see that the original media takes up 13 gigabytes, but there's no optimized and there's no proxy media. So we could select a single clip and we could transcode that to ProRes proxy or to H.264 proxy. And as we've seen, we can decide how small we want that to be. So let's make this 50% and say OK. And now when you come over to the inspector, you'll notice that it's slightly different. It's showing that you've got no proxy and no optimized media, but you do have original. But what's happening here is that Final Cut is actually transcoding that. And until it's transcoded, it won't show as a green dot over here. You can also transcode in the inspector, and there's your same options there that we had a minute ago. And on import, when you bring up the import window, then you could transcode to create proxy media. And again, you have the same choices as we had previously, and then import with whatever you want to there. And if we look at this library now, and then look over here, the inspector, there's the same size original footage, but the optimized media takes up 268 gigs and the proxy media takes up 25 gigs. And also, if you hover over the clip in the browser, you'll notice that that says that it's optimized media. And this one doesn't show optimized media, so we know that that one's not optimized. And if we select that clip and then come over here, you can see that it's neither optimized nor does it have proxy. If we select this clip, we can see that it's got optimized and proxy. Now, the big advantage of having small proxy files is that means that you can work offline. The small proxy files will not stress the processor on your laptop, and nor will you fill up your hard disk with large files. So how are we going to go about achieving creating a library with just a small proxy file? Now, this current library has the original footage, optimized footage, and proxy footage, and that footage is at, proxy footage is at 50%. So what we could do is accept the 50%, or we could delete the 50% that's currently there by selecting all of the files, that's Command A, and then coming to the file menu, delete generated data for the proxy media. If we select it and look over here, you can see the proxy's been taken out. Now we could do the same thing by Command A, selecting all, and now right-clicking on it, we will transcode that to the proxy media size we want. So let's accept 264 and we'll go to 25% because previously we've been comfortable with that. And now to create a new library with that proxy media at 25% without the optimize and without the original media, we can simply select the library and come to Copy to Library and create a new library, name it, and then we've got the choice of what we put in that library, either the original media, the optimized media, or the proxy media. So in this case, we'll put in the proxy media because we've already created that at 25%. And so that new library now will have proxy media. It hasn't been created yet because it's still being rendered. But if we check over here, we can see there's a limited amount of original media, and you will always need to have something in there, but only 700 megabytes. Currently, there's no optimized and currently no proxy, but you know that we did save the proxy media. So we'll come back to this when it's completed. So now we're back with the project after it has been transcoded, and we can see in here that there is 2 gigabytes worth of proxy there. And so if we were to come up here, we could see we're currently selected on Proxy Preferred. If we select on Proxy Only, there's no change. But if we do select on Optimize, then there is no optimized media in that project. So now what do we want to do to relink our original media. We'll need to select the library and come to the File menu and select Relink Files and Original Media. Here are all the original files. We'll locate those. There is original, and this one has original in it, and select that. It's now found those 22 files, so we can relink those now. And there they are back, so that you could now export this project with its edits that you've done offline. And of course, if you've got Proxy Media selected in your view menu, then you do need to switch back to Optimized Media before you export. However, Final Cut will remind you with this warning message. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.